another.
What I want to talk with you personally about Sergeant Scott, you heard about him putting these drug people down.
Yeah.
And he could have called for help.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what I'm saying is, if we know what the problem is, we got the men to handle it. But no, he wanted to handle it on his own.
Mm-hmm.
But, do you feel he could be a suspect?
I do and I don't.
Go on.
The way he acts at certain places, he has a tendency to overstate stuff, and like he's covering up something as a suspect. And then at other times, you would think he was innocent. So, I don't know, either way.
Well, I say, what I'm confused about now, well, if he had anything to do with the disappearance of Jim Benson, it would be enough attention for him.
No.
He's got to have these news reports. But if it'd been some foul play, he would want to cover his name. So,
yeah.
That's what I'm thinking about. He would have had to have covered his name.
Yeah, you got a point there. Yeah.
Mr. Howard, I want to take this opportunity to thank you for your donation to our Help the Homeless program.
Oh, you're such a bleeding heart liberal, John.
Well, my heart bleeds a little for the underprivileged.
Well, the homeless are beating our brains out. If they can't find work, they ought to stick them in a concentration camp.
Well, you must have a soft spot in your heart. I hear you donated much of the office space here to the Sheriff's Department.
Triggered you off?
Oh, I'm not triggered off. I just came by to compliment you on the fine job you did in bringing down these four drug lords. You could have called for backup.
All of these were a species that needed to be eliminated. They were scum of the earth. They needed to be put out of the way.
Well, what I'm saying is, it would have been a whole lot safer for you. When you got the evidence, just brought out the squat team. Brought out as many people as you needed, but no, you wanted all the glory.
The judges are not executing. The vigilantes are way behind the times. Look at all the lives that could be saved if you could execute them before they do any more crimes.
Sergeant Scott, I'm sure that vigilantes are behind time, but you wouldn't be happy being a vigilante. You know why? Because you want all the credit. You want the news reports in the paper and over TV. You want to make Citizen of the Year again. And you're getting by with it. I want you to know that I've eliminated you as a suspect in this Jim Benson case because it's not out in the open.
Hey, mister. It's in the bag.
this, is my crime bag. I'm collecting DNA or anything that I can collect to convict a killer.
Okay, so he wasn't the person that I was looking for. It don't change the fact he's no angel.
We just brought this gentleman in, didn't we?
Well, Sheriff Winslow, I know you've been in law enforcement for years. Now, I've had schooling as an investigator, but what suggestions can you give me?
Well, I'm from the old school. I'm pretty sure they don't do the things we done back then. But we bring these suspects into a dark room, and we put a light on. Question whether that light seems to bring the truth out of them or bring suspicion. You know, they sort of squint, and you ask them things and they say they don't know, and they sort of stutter and stammer, and you'd be surprised what that dark room and that light in their face would do. You can see the expressions on their face, and you can pretty well tell without a lie detector where they're telling the truth or where they're not. And that's really a good effect. I know they don't do that now, but you ought to try it sometime. I believe you'll get some good response.
Okay, that's good advice. What I want to ask you, do you think that, Jim Benz could be posing as what it is? He has been known to work and see me.
Oh, okay.
And what I'm saying is, right now, Mr. Howard is supposedly be living in Virginia. Mm-hmm. And before he left Maryland, it's been a new sidewalk.
That's likely. That's very likely that could happen. Yeah. So they sort of pick and choose what they want to do to throw suspicion.
So what I'm saying is, if Jim Benson turns out to be posing as Mr. Howard, maybe we ought to dig that sidewalk up.
Yeah. I bet you that, yeah, you can probably find something.
Possibly it's Mr. Howard that's missing.
That's right. Yeah, but he was just putting that sidewalk in out of the blue. There had to be a reason for it. He didn't do it just to get exercise.
No, because what I'm saying, he's worked just enough to impress the people that he's been around.
Yeah.
And he knows when to leave. He'll bum in on somebody, and normally he knows when he's been there enough, so he'll welch off somebody else.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That'd be good to check into.
Okay. Well, okay, I'll
be... our brains out. If they can't find work, they ought to stick them in a concentration camp.
Well, you must have a soft spot in your heart. I hear you donated much of the office space here to the Sheriff's Department.
What triggered you off?
Oh, I'm not triggered off. I just came by to compliment you on the fine job you did in bringing down these four drug lords. You could have called for backup.
All of these were a species that needed to be eliminated. They were scum of the earth. They needed to be put out of the way.
Well, what I'm saying is it would have been a whole lot safer for you. When you got the evidence, just brought out the squat team. Brought out as many people as you needed, but no, you wanted all the glory.
The judges are not executing. The vigilantes are way behind the time. Look at all the lives that could be saved if you could execute them before they do any more crimes.
Sergeant Scott, I'm sure that vigilantes are behind time, but you wouldn't be happy being a vigilante. You know why? Because you want all the credit. You want the news reports in the paper and over TV. You want to make Citizen of the Year again. And you're getting by with it. I want you to know that I've eliminated you as a suspect in this Jim Benson case because it's not out in the open.
Hey, mister. It's in the bag.
This. what I want to talk with you personally about Sergeant Scott. You heard about him putting these drug people down.
Yeah.
And he could have called for help.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what I'm saying is, if we know what the problem is, we got the men to handle it. But no, he wanted to handle it on his own.
Mm-hmm.
But, do you feel he could be a suspect?
I do and I don't.
Go on. What suggestions can you give me?
Well, I'm from the old school. I'm pretty sure they don't do the things we done back then. But we bring these suspects into a dark room. And we put a light on them. And we question them. Well, that light seems to bring the truth out of them or bring suspicion. You know, they sort of squint. And you ask them things and they say they don't know. And they sort of stutter and stammer. And you'd be surprised what that dark room and that light in their face would do. You can see the expressions on their face, and you can pretty well tell without a lie detector whether they're telling the truth or whether they're not. And that's really a good effect. I know they don't do that now, but you ought to try it sometime. I believe you'll get some good response.
Okay, that's good advice. What I wanted to ask you, do you think that Jim Benz could be posing as what it is, he has been known to work and see me.
Oh, okay.
And what I'm saying is right now Mr. Howard is supposedly be living in Virginia. Mm-hmm. And before he left Maryland, it's been a new sidewalk.
That's likely. That's very likely that could happen, yeah. Because they sort of pick and choose what they want to do to throw suspicion.
So what I'm saying is, if Jim Besson turns out to be posing as Mr. Howard, maybe we ought to dig that sidewalk up.
I bet you that, you can probably find something.
Possibly it's Mr. Howard that's missing.
That's right. Yeah, him just putting that sidewalk in out of the blue, there had to be a reason for it. He didn't do it just to get exercise.
No, because what I'm saying, he's worked just enough to impress the people that he's been around.
Yeah.
And he knows when to leave. He'll bum in on somebody, and normally he knows when he's been there enough, so he'll welch off somebody else.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That'd be good to check into.
Okay. Well, okay,
Mr. Howard, I want to take this opportunity to thank you for your donation to our Help the Homeless program.
Oh, you're such a bleeding heart liberal, John. Well, my heart bleeds a little for the underprivileged. Well, the homeless are beating our brains out. If they can't find work, they ought to stick them in a concentration camp.
Well, you must have a soft spot in your heart. I hear you donated much of the office space here to the Sheriff's Department.
What triggered you off?
Oh, I'm not triggered off. I just came by to compliment you on the fine job you did in bringing down these four drug lords. You could have called for backup.
All of these were a species that needed to be eliminated. They were scum of the earth. They needed to be put out of the way.
Well, what I'm saying is it would have been a whole lot safer for you. When you got the evidence, just brought out the squat team. Brought out as many people as you needed, but no, you wanted all the glory.
The judges are not executing. The vigilantes are way behind the time. Look at all the lives that could be saved if you could execute them before they do any more crimes.
Sergeant Scott, I'm sure that vigilantes are behind time, but you wouldn't be happy being a vigilante. You know why? Because you want all the credit. You want the news reports in the paper and over TV. You want to make Citizen of the Year again. And you're getting by with it. I want you to know that I've eliminated you as a suspect in this Jim Benson case because it's not out in the open.